This video tutorial I will explain how to create an employee record using different layers in Spring Boot application. Here you can see three different layers: controller layer, service layer and repository layer. Here you can see Postman client, which sends a create employee request to controller layer. Then request goes to service layer. Then request goes to repository layer. And repository layer insert employee record to employee table in the database. And the create employee response goes back to Postman client. For controller layer, we will create employee service controller class and annotate with REST controller. For service layer, we will create the class employee service impl and annotate with service. And for repository layer, we will create employee repository class and annotate with repository. Here you can see ArcDB and it has employee table and it does not have any record. We will see how to insert one record. Here you can see Spring Boot application with folder structure. And here you can see pom.xml. I have included the dependencies of web, JDBC, MySQL connector. Here you can see application.properties file. Here I have defined driver class name, URL of the database, and username and password of the database. Using this information, the Spring Boot application makes connection to the MySQL database. Here I have defined the class employee. It has four properties: ID, name, age, and salary. And getter and setter methods for these four properties. And here I have overridden toString method. Here I have defined a class employee repository, which is a repository class. And here I have defined JDBC template object. And I have put auto-wired annotation. So when Spring Boot application starts, it creates a JDBC template object and inject here. And it has a create employee method, which accept employee object. And in this method, I have written code to insert employee record to employee table. Here I have defined the SQL. And using update method of JDBC template object, I am inserting employee record to employee table. The auto-generated primary key I am capturing here, generated employee ID. And that I am setting to ID property of employee object and returns the employee object. Here I have defined the interface employee service and it has a create employee abstract method. Here I have defined a class employee service impl, which implements employee service interface and provide implementation of create employee method. From this method, we are calling create employee method of employee repository object, and employee service simple is service class. Here I have defined a class employee service controller, which is the REST controller, and it has a create employee method which accept employee object as a request body. To call this method, we have to send request to this path and method should be post. In this method, we are calling create employee method of employee service object and passing employee object. And once employee record is created in employee table, we are returning responses employee is created successfully with the generated primary key. Here I have defined a class application, which is a Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application in debug mode. Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. Using Postman client, I am going to send employee create request to the Spring Boot application. Here is the URL and the method is post. And body type you have to select raw, and we are going to send JSON. And here I have defined employee object in JSON format. Name is Peter, age is 45, and salary is 90,000. Sending the request, and it came to the controller, then to the service class, then it came to repository class. And here we got the response. Employee is created successfully with the ID 4. And status is 201 created. Refresh. And here you can see. One employee record is created. And primary key is 4. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more. And here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.